It's been 2 years since I built the first Argon, and I have yet to complete getting this motor to drive the Argon. That's my current project. These are out of automotive electric windows or window regulators. This one runs about 88 RPM. This one's probably closer to about 75. Leads me to believe that this is out of a driver's side window. Driver's side windows often run quite a bit faster than passenger side. This takes a plug. It's got a little detent in here that latches in here so it won't come unplugged. They wanted entirely too much money for one of these plugs, so I said forget about it. Using a Dremel tool, I sliced this plug through this section and down both sides and cut the end off. And I'm leaving this back here as a support for what I'm going to do here. Just using these bayonet plugs, I'm going to push one on here and just engage it on one side and push another one on here and engage it on one side. Then I will use some epoxy and I will pour epoxy in here to lock these in place and to prevent any possibility of these shorting out. And I'll put a zip tie around the motor and put this back in the Argon. In a previous video, I reduced the original diameter of this part, which opened up these pockets between these spokes. Now I made this part to match this, and this will be the drive pulley for the motor. I need to be able to transfer torque between this part and this. I installed these three screws. I used a Dremel tool to grind pockets in three spots to match up with the screws. And I used the Dremel tool to reduce this face of the screw heads for a little more clearance. You can use a bright light to make sure that you're not getting too thin on some of the areas in the plastic. You would not want to damage the drive teeth. When I put this together, I don't have to worry about this coming out, but I do need to transmit torque. And I don't want to initially have or to be able to develop any play in there as this thing is being used. So I'll put some epoxy in here to engage with those screws, and that'll be a good firm drive. This is just sitting here engaged with the motor. I have a speed control, a 12-volt battery, and we'll just see how loud this is. Now that's full speed on the speed control, which is about 10 RPM slower than if it was connected directly to the battery. And we can slow this down a little bit. I expect to be operating about here. So now we'll play the Argon, see if you pay any attention to this at all. So even though this is a little bit noisy, I don't think it's going to be extremely noticeable while it's playing the Argon. I made this support with three indexing dowels, and the center dowel is the outside support for this pulley. Because that spline shaft that's in there, it just engages. It needs something to hold it in and to pull in the opposite direction of what this polyurethane belting is running. So I can remove these two screws and take this off, then that pulley will come off. This is still an experiment to see how this motor does and how this drives. This motor could be a little bit faster, and it's not a continuous duty motor, so it is warming up playing the Argon. At this point in time, I've given up on the speed control because it slows us down too much. So I'm just running it direct drive off of the 12-volt battery. Then if I engage it, this, I know I got the wires backwards on the motor. Slight delay when it comes up on compression on the two bellows, and that's at least in part because this pulley down here is a bit too smooth. This belt is pretty tight and I'm still getting some slippage down here. So it's an experiment.